Hi everybody, Missy Morgan. I just wanted to do another quick video of how to set up your classrooms on the ELA, the secondary ELA, which is the SpringBoard. So it's really important to actually go through SpringBoard on our SharePoint or from our staff portal. And the same thing goes for students. They have to go through FUSD.com student portal and click SpringBoard. If they just Google it, they could end up in what I say, Connecticut, because the login is specific for Fontana Unified. And this is super important because I've had so many kids that have come up and been like, oh, hey, I can't log in. It's not taking my login information. But I look up here and it's like Pierce, Connecticut or something crazy. So they have to go in through the portal and you do too. So I'm going to log in. And then I'm going to go ahead and go to my class roster. Now, I have my periods already set up, 3, 4, and 5. But if you don't, you wouldn't have this here. So you would need to click that roster and then go to create class. You could do period 1, English language arts. You could put a period in there if you want. Start date. We could go ahead and put it as March 1st. End date, obviously, is going to be May 29th. And then you're going to click Create Class. Okay, so it says one of your classes need products. Please add them now. So you're going to click on here and you're going to have to find the book. So I know that this is 11th grade, so I would just click it, add selected products, and then you're good. Now you have this access code. You are going to want to copy and paste that and provide that to the students. When they log in, they will be at the SpringBoard student view, which is different. They'll have to click new to SpringBoard. They'll put in their access code and they will be able to log in. SpringBoard generates them a login. The password, however, has to be very complex. It has to be a certain amount of characters, you have to have capitals, and you have to have a special character like an exclamation point. So for me, I went ahead and just gave my students a blanket password. I did SB, Springboard, KHS, Kaiser High School, and then 2021, because that's the year that my juniors are graduating with an exclamation point at the end. For the most part, most of my kids have gotten it. And then what I did also was ask them to go here to sticky notes and type in your passwords and you can keep a log of it. You log in the first time you'll have to log in with your Microsoft Office 365 account, but then after that, it will log all your notes. And so even if you log into a different computer, your notes will be there. And so, if you have your logins for like Springboard and everything else, it'll be there. It's just an easier way and something that I've been teaching the kids to do. So, that is how you set up your Springboard classroom. From there, you can go into the home button there, go into your books. You've got a grade book, the Zinc Reading Lab, things like that. And I'll make another video maybe that goes into that a little bit more. Okay, well, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them. Have a great day.